Welcome to this presentation where we're going to talk about using the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes to create CSI snapshots and clones. My name is Michael Madsen. I'm a tech marketing engineer with Hewlett Packard Enterprise. First, I'm going to walk through a couple of slides here before I go over to my demo. The HPE CSI driver supports a number of different products from HPE, like HPE Nimble Storage, HPE Primera, and a few other platforms, right? And these platforms plug into Kubernetes using their REST APIs and data path by deploying the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes on top of Kubernetes. And the respective container storage provider speaks to the backend, and you will then get access to a number of different API objects. And the API objects that we're going to talk about today is primarily the volume snapshot class and the volume snapshot. The volume snapshot class is created by the cluster admin, who basically declares this cluster-wide object that allows users to create something called a volume snapshot. The volume snapshot will then reference the volume snapshot class name. You will also be able to specify which persistent volume claim that you want to snapshot. There's also a number of other ways you can create clones from volume snapshots that are not illustrated here, and we're going to talk about that later in the demo. To enable volume snapshots on your Kubernetes cluster, you need to do a number of different things. And we've outlined this on the documentation portal that we have for the HPE CSI drivers. If you go to scod.hpedev.io and click to underneath HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes, you go to using, and there is a tab there called enabling CSI snapshots. You install a couple of snapshot beta CRDs and the snapshot controller, and you kind of do this once per cluster. We also describe here on how to use CSI snapshots. So this is kind of where I'm starting, right? So I have this volume snapshot class that you see in the example here deployed on my cluster. There's the volume snapshot class, and I also have a default storage class installed. Throughout the demo, while I create snapshots and clone those snapshots, etc., I'm going to use the latest Redis stable Helm chart to illustrate how this works. My values.yaml file contains only one line, and that is basically that we want to run Redis in append-only mode, which makes all keys that you commit to the store persistent. All right, that came up quick and easy. And now I'm going to connect to my Redis instance. I'm going to set a key, HPE, I'm going to give it a value, Kubernetes. And we can also see that three different persistent volume claims were created during deployment of this Helm chart. In my volume snapshots YAML file here, I have three different snapshots, right? So I'm going to create one snapshot on each persistent volume claim. And I reference the persistent volume claim name, and I give the snapshot a unique name. Next, I need to create three new claims from that particular snapshot that I created. Since we're using Helm and we're using the same Helm chart throughout here, the names of the persistent volume claims that Redis uses have a deterministic naming, right? So I named my first instance prod, and I'm going to name my next instance test. So I can simply give that persistent volume claim test in the claim name instead of prod. You can also see here in this persistent volume claim spec data source that we are referencing the volume snapshot that we just created. Create the persistent volume claims. Next, we want to start a new Redis instance. We name it test. And once this instance come up, we will connect to it and check if the key that we inserted in the prod instance actually exists. Yep, there we go. There's our key, HPE. So now I'm going to set the key to a different value, new Kubernetes. And I'm going to show you how you would basically clone a existing persistent volume claim without using a snapshot. In my clones.yaml file here, I have a persistent volume claim that's going to reference a data source, which is a different persistent volume claim. We're going to name this instance clone, and due to the deterministic naming, we can just insert that name instead of prod and test. I'm going to create my clones, bring up the clone instance, And once this instance come up, we can connect to the clone instance and get the new key. There we go, new Kubernetes. And just to illustrate that the production instance that I deployed initially hasn't been affected, I'm going to connect to the prod instance and get the original key. As you can see here, that get HPE and it spells out Kubernetes, which was the original value we set that key to. I've put together a summary slide to kind of illustrate a little bit better what actually happened on a cluster. When we deployed the initial Helm chart for the production instance, the PVCs got created. We got a PV created on the cluster as well. And that then mapped to a physical volume on my backend storage array. And once all these objects were created, the prod instance was able to come up. Then we created a volume snapshot on the persistent volume claim. That creates an object on the cluster called a volume snapshot content. And that refers to a snapshot that is a physical resource on the backend storage system. Next, when we brought up the test instance, three new PVCs got created that refers to the volume snapshot. New persistent volume claims gets created, and on the physical array, three new clones were created that were derived from the snapshot that we created in the previous step. And after those objects were created, the test instance come up. The last operation, when we created the clone instance, we created PVCs from existing PVCs. New PVs were created with that information, and on the physical array, new snapshots were created and clones were derived from that snapshot, and the clone instance was then able to start. And that is all that I had for today. If you like what you see here and would like to see more, please visit hpe.com/storage/containers to learn more. Until next time, take care.